yes, it is. It's so unfair.
Run, son of a bitch.
Does she look at all familiar?
Blonde, big tits, blank expression. Yeah. That was race type.
Do you think he might have been involved with her?
What do I care?
Thank you, Mrs. Hodge. And as soon as the coroner has finished with his autopsy, I'll have Mr. Hodge's body returned to you for reburial.
Don't bother. As far as I'm concerned, you can burn him. And I'm not talking some fancy cremation either. I'm talking gasoline, paint thinner, and strike a match.
But hang in, and I know we can make this breast cancer benefit our best ever. Mona, the goodie bags. Tell us.
First, we have the pink ribbon breast cancer cookie.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, what's wrong with the cookie?
They need something more inspirational or outrageous than a fucking cookie. Well, the cookies are donated, so we're having them. But you're right. We do need something inspirational and outrageous to give to these women. So I'm giving them you.
Excuse me?
I'd like you to make a little speech before you bring me up.
But what would I say?
Something inspirational. Something you think they'd like to hear. But my husband's parents, the Liebermans, are coming. So please, try not to say fuck so much.
We have reason to believe she was with your husband just prior to her murder.
Gina from Philly?
Yes.
I can't believe she was down here with us. I can't believe you did this to me.
Ma'am, I'm with the Miami Crime Lab and not the FBI. Can you tell me where your husband might be?
Frank? Probably out spending his cash.
Ed, ma'am, please. His alias is Ed.
Ed, Frank, Gothrocks, Mr. Ideal in cash only, whatever, all right?
Did he ever give you any?
He never did in Philly. I don't know why it would start now. I sneak it out of his wallet while he's sleeping.
You have any on you now?
What if I did?
I could catch him with it.
Hadn't kept Gina, I never would have done this. We have month-to-month leases.
Fantastic.
You're on that show. Five Towns, right?
Indeed I am.
I knew it!
You a fan?
My daughter is. She loves that young boy who's always taking his shirt off. Cutie. So, doesn't the star of his own TV show want something bigger?
No, a loft is all I need.
You should get a little extra space, drama.
I'll get extra space when I know if my show gets picked up. I'm not getting sucked into the trappings of celebrity life again. I'm not doing it.
Okay. Here we are. Next up, Captain Leland Stottlemyre. Who wants to take this handsome stud home, huh? Captain Stottlemyre plays guitar and claims to be quite handy around the house. Mr. Monk is a former homicide detective, now working as a private consultant. He has worked on many famous cases. And let's start the bidding at $200. Do I hear $200? Ladies, this is a world-class detective. Maybe you have a husband or a boyfriend who needs following. Maybe you can't find your car keys.
Yes. I can't hear the doctor, Marlene.
I'm trying to get Sid here so he can come over and sign the papers. What time is he going under the knife?
Later this afternoon.
Tell him to be here by 12 or we get another lawyer.
Yes.
Bye.
Sure. Yes. Just
to... I want everything to be in order just in case.
Marlene. I don't want to think about just in case when I'm about to go into major surgery.
Stop being so melodramatic, Arthur. It's a bypass.
Mrs. Bransky, it's going to be fine.
I have.
Maybe you ought to tell him that.
He knows. Can I see him?
He'll be in his room in about an hour.
Here, take these. If I gave Arthur flowers, he'd have a coronary.